We want to bring you up to date on a breaking story that we've been following for about the last 90 minutes right now. Police and firefighters searching a well underneath the back deck of a vacant home in the Northland. This in connection with day 8 of the case involving missing 10-month-old Lisa Irwin. The scene of this search, Northeast 38th and North Brighton, just a few blocks from the Irwin home. Let us first go to KMBC 9's Peggy Bright, who is at the scene right now. Peggy.
Kris, we can see a vacuum truck is now just backing into place here. And what that truck is apparently going to be doing is sucking all of the water out of the bottom of the well there. This is just the latest in an effort that's now about 2 hours along, in an effort to look beneath the deck of this home to see whether or not anything could have been dropped down there, especially because this is all because of Lisa Irwin. Now, what we know right now is that police came here, were told by neighbors apparently that there is a well behind this house underneath the deck, which is on the house, and so they decided to come here and just be extremely thorough. They want to look inside and make sure that nothing has been dropped inside of there. In the meantime, 38th Street to Parvin Road, North Brighton is closed. So again, avoid this area. If you need to go north-south in this area, try Shoto instead of North Brighton because it is closed down between Parvin Road and 38th Street. Back to you, Kris.
And likely to stay this way for a while. Let's now go to KMBC 9's Brenda Washington. And as Peggy Bright pointed out, this search this afternoon, the result of a law enforcement canvas, not a specific tip.
You are so right, Kris. I'm going to show you. We've got a close-up view also of the water department truck that is here. They have moved it since to get a better angle so they can start pumping the water out of what we're told is a well here. Now, this house, we're told, has been vacant for a number of years, at least 4 years. In fact, it was so overgrown with vines and trees with the chimney crashing in that people didn't even know there was a house here until neighbors took it upon themselves to clean this house up. Now, where they are, as far as that deck and that well, it's on the west side of the house, again, where you see that water department truck. Now, Marty Hildeman is another resident here in the area. And, Marty, you were saying that at this point, no one even knew there was a deck or a well back there.
No.
Because the house, describe how the house was looking.
Yeah, just all covered with vines and trees.
Now, describe, do a lot of houses have wells in the back or what here in the neighborhood?
No, usually just septic tanks.
But they're calling this, right at this time, a well. And you were saying that if it's a well, that it most likely would have an opening large enough to, you know, dump something like a baby. Your thoughts right now as to all of this?
Yeah, just a bad scene.
Okay, well, I can tell you right now that we still have plenty of law enforcement here on the scene. Again, the water department, I can see them getting the boom in place as they try to begin pumping water out of what we're told is a well on the west side of this house on Northeast 39th and North Brighton right here. Again, we want to let you know nothing has been confirmed that anything has been found in that well. Again, this is not a tip. Law enforcement canvassing the area, they continue doing this, saw this house and thought, hey, we better check it just in case. But of course, as soon as we find out if anything is found, we'll bring that to you. So, Kris, back to you.
Brenda, thank you. Quite an operation, certainly, as we see these live pictures from News Chopper 9 HD's Johnny Rollins. And Johnny, we understand this is about a 3-foot-wide, 25 to 30-foot deep well, right?
Well, from what we understand, that's what it looks like from up here. And I'll tell you what, it's just really hard to hover over this. We just don't have any wind this morning and a lot of thermal activity. So if we're bouncing around a little bit, apologies. But, yeah, we saw the water department truck come in here probably a half an hour ago. They started laying pipe and preparing to, as Peggy said, suck the water out of the well, from what we understand, just to be sure that they have done a thorough search. This house, again, facing west along North Brighton. It is shut down, as they said, as well, between 38th and North Brighton right now as this continues. Johnny Rollins, News Chopper 9, back to you in the studio.
Johnny, thank you. Now to KMBC 9's Michael Mahoney, part of our team coverage there on the ground. Michael?
Yeah, good afternoon, Kris. I'm behind this house, which faces Brighton onto to the east, and we're probably 100, maybe 200 yards to the west up on a slight rise, and can confirm pretty much everything that Peggy told you a little bit earlier about these septic tank or drainage tank moving into position to try and drain this well or a septic tank. It should be noted that this part of North Kansas City North had a lot of septic tanks in it before it was annexed by the city. back many, many years ago. So everybody's on city water out here now, but the presence of septic tanks or wells isn't too much of a surprise because of the one-time rural nature of it. And what we can see from here is the back of this truck moving into place, a number of investigators and police officers standing by, getting ready to find out whatever they're going to find out on this, and we'll be standing here to find out and learn with them. Chris?
KMBC 9's Michael Mahoney also in the Northland this afternoon. We will keep our eyes on this search as it continues. Of course, you can look at live streaming video from News Chopper 9 HD's Johnny Rollins. Updates as they become necessary. Of course, full reports tonight on KMBC 9 News at 5 and 6.